Hey, thanks a lot, everybody, for showing up today. It's pretty windy out there, big storm coming in, so appreciate y'all kind of showing up for this meeting today. Well, let's just get right into it. People are kind of already starting to ask, what's 2010 looking like? What was my take on 2009? Obviously, the bank-owned homes have been pretty much ruling the market, as you all know. And so the buyers, of course, have just, my analogy is we're in a seller's market in a buyer's market under 200,000. Any of you buyers that are out there trying to buy these homes under 200,000, you know that ever since about, March, April of this year, there's been multiple offers on any good home that comes in. And that's back when we had 200 or 300 bank-owned properties. Now we're less than 100 bank-owned properties in all of the Reno Sparks area. And I would venture to say that of those 100 properties, there's probably half of them that are kind of, can I use the word dogs? Oh, I'm going to use it anyhow. Kind of dogs that aren't going to sell anyhow, and they've been a long time. The other half are just kind of maybe slightly overpriced. Maybe they're older. Maybe they've got the cabinets ripped out or something like that. And also, the ones that we're seeing just tremendous activity on, when they hit the market, they pretty much have 10, 15 offers at once, are probably the ones a lot of you guys are wishing you could get. Those are those little, anywhere from, say, 1,200 square feet to maybe 2,800, 3,000 square foot tops, 322s or more stucco homes in the subdivisions that offer a few amenities. As you know, these things are just going very fast. And it's getting harder and harder to get these things. So what I'm coaching my buyers on right now today is get a good deal, don't try for a great deal. Because right now we are again at the lowest interest rates ever. So don't gamble on trying to save that extra 5%, because that extra 5% you're trying to save, if the interest rates tick back up even 0.25%, that 5% is a wash, okay? Get a roof over your head, all right? A lot of you guys aren't investors. You don't need the very best deal, okay? So just get that roof over your head. So what's 2010 gonna look like? Ooh, boy. I think we're gonna probably see some more bank-owned inventory hitting late winter, early spring, and there won't be as much demand then to close, because then this new tax credit extension will be phasing out by then. So we should be able to get some more bank-owned inventory there, which of course is what everybody's chasing. Those tend to dominate the market. Mom and pop are finally able to maybe bite the bullet a little bit and sell their homes, with a huge loss of equity. The short sales are going through a lot easier now. In fact, the Obama administration, as we speak, is putting pressure on the banks doing short sales to expedite those more, as well as doing loan modifications. So, before I get off on the market again too much, the process I like for sellers I'm advising is try a loan modification first, okay? You got nothing to lose. Then let's try your short sales. And then if that doesn't work, sure. Unfortunately, if you go into foreclosure, that's a very sad thing. But if you do go into foreclosure, the general consensus, what a lot of people are doing, is don't move out of your house, okay? Stay there until somebody knocks on your door, literally. And then simply look them in the face and go, I would like cash for keys, what's your offer? Now I'm talking, this is after you no longer own the property. Have your stuff packed up, ready to go, but they will come and offer you cash for keys. There's been some people that have been able to stay in their house rent-free, not even being bothered, for up to a year after they've been foreclosed on, because they're slipping through the cracks. So heads up on that one for a lot of you people struggling there. I'm not advising you to do this. I'm just telling you some people have done that. So 2010, we're looking at most activity, probably still going to be under 250, hoping for some bank-owned inventory to increase. The 500,000 and above is still going to be a tough pill to swallow. You're going to need large down payments. You're going to need excellent credit. The million and above, we're hoping to get some kind of stabilization. The very few buyers that we've had in the $1 million above, the doctors and some bankruptcy attorneys that have been very busy. They've kind of pulled back into the shell a little bit. The doctors right now are afraid to go out and buy $1 million plus home because they're not sure what this health care plan will bring if they're going to be regulated. But that's kind of it for what I think is going to happen in 2010, if you can make sense of it at all. If you go to my website, ronbellrealtor.com, you just under categories, click on statistics, local market, anything like that. We hammer these statistics all the time. We're constantly posting fresh data. A lot of times I'll put these videos up. So thanks for tuning in. RonBellRealtor.com. Have a good day.